Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your wandering Ronin, Mr. Joe, and we're doing a little preview of what's about to happen for the next Risk Legacy game. On the board here, we have laid out the new draft mode that got unlocked with Trav hitting his second victory. When it comes around to the setup that we're going to do off camera, we're each going to roll a die. Highest roll will be the first pick of the draft. The order goes clockwise from them. They will pick a card of either their faction, their starting troop count, their turn order for the actual game, the starting placement, and their starting number of coins in hand. Each player clockwise will pick after that until it gets to the last player in the draft, at which point they will pick a second of any particular category, and it will go in reverse order. So first pick will also have, in a five-player game, the 10th pick. The last pick of the first round, that fifth pick, will have the immediate next pick. And it's a way of the game trying to make it a little bit more fair. But it does mean somebody could potentially start trying to cherry pick as their strategy for unfolds. But we're going to do that off camera because it's probably going to be a hot mess. And we will try to rearrange ourselves when we're playing so that we're in a consecutive turn order as according to the turn order we've drafted. We're going to be starting this up fairly shortly, so we will take about 15 minutes off camera, and you'll see us in about another 15 seconds. And welcome back, folks. We've done our draft mode, and while the situation on the board will not really be relevant until we start fighting amongst each other for victory, what is relevant is the turn order. Josh is player one in terms of turn order, and we're going clockwise. And he has the Enclave of the Bear and his setup in the Middle East. Feel free to wreck faces.
Don't bear face.
Homeland is Ursaheim, the cradle of bear civilization. We yearn to have our home back. And we will take it. Well, that was anticlimactic.
Quiet. No one, in fact, started in the breadbasket that is Africa. Not necessarily for any other reason other than, well, the Middle East was going to invade Africa promptly.
No, I'm good.
Okay. My turn. Now Mechanica reinforces with our Space Marines. No one shall ever know the true nature of these Sonic Marines. All of them.
They don't do anything.
And I'm done after conquering through Mega Koopia Conzer City? Was that the
Conzer City?
Conzer City and Cooptopia.
Oh, excuse me, I took back Ursaheim and Cheeseburger.
All of the cheese for my bear brother.
You, sir, will be very, very healthy.
And constipated.
Yes.
Extremely constipated.
You don't want to see when 1,000 bears are constipated.
So just to go and simplify the movement.
We could see early combat. Doubtful.
Early combat.
Ammo shortages, they got.
Early combat.
I mean, I'll go and do you a solid if we have, you know, at least a temporary truce until you get things resolved over here.
Oh, there was already a truce. Like, I wasn't even going to go into America or North America.
How is this backstab everyone?
I'm
going to
turn Argentina into a biohazard.
Yes.
That's what I want to see.
Alright.
Bam! Shit is getting real already.
Well, you did start his game. Another for the destroy bot.
Alright. So how's this go again? Do I get anything?
So you get three dudes, because that's the minimum.
And then mutants get extra for fallout, I believe. Or is it just biohazard?
For the record, the biohazard space on the board means that if you're in there, you lose a troop, basically.
Unless you're mutants,
unless you're mutants.
Just reverse their mutants, yeah.
Yeah, and then gain people. And for the rest of us mercenaries, we gain a troop. Mercenaries don't like mutants, so they kill off.
When do you get your little stars? Because if I control all biohazard territories, which is going to happen,
and
Fallout territory earns you a star. Like, as soon as I grab all of them, like, if I was, like...
That is a star that's permanently on your card. Mm-hmm. You have it as long as that condition is kept.
Word. And what do the stars do again?
You need four.
Four to win. Congratulations, there's your first star. For now.
These are three guys, ready? Gonna roll some dump trucks out to Brazil. God knows they need to be cleaned up a little bit over there.
And take some north out of Africa with that bunker right there.
That's definitely an option.
I mean, if you don't, he's definitely going to next round and make it a pain.
I'm still probably going to take it next.
He is the bears.
There will be combat.
There is nothing wrong with a fortified truce.
I did that wrong.
It ain't that I don't trust you. It's just that I've played games with you before.
I'm done. I'm done diggity. I've conquered.
So I get three.
Yep.
Yes.
What is that? Blacktopia.
I doubt it.
Blanktopia.
Blanktopia. And I own New Madagascar, by the way.
Yeah, which means you, since you're the one who named New Madagascar, will get an extra troop for controlling that entire territory.
Is that, that's like a forever?
As long as you, the player, are controlling that territory.
I didn't know that it did that, but like, I thought that was like a one game kind of thing.
No, that's for naming the territory.
I'm a beast. So hard capturing all that wing.
I know, right?
Well, yeah, because it's hot.
It's hot over in New Madagascar. Mm.
That it?
Yeah. All right.
Damn, first turn looking real.
Interesting.
All right, so my turn?
You're just going to finish out Africa, or do you have any aspirations on Europe?
Wouldn't be wrong for me to go after Europe, I don't think.
Nah, but that, and also the Enclave of the Bear. We are the OG genetically modified humanoids on this side. Get the fuck out of Africa. So, just dump truck, get it done.
Defense!
Don't trust action. You subtract one from your lowest defense die.
He adds one to his highest defense die because of the bunkers.
You roll.
Yeah, you can't not roll maximum.
Ugh.
The bears take early casualties of four.
Yeah, because I rolled terrible. So I lose two?
Yep. Continue your assault with three?
Yeah.
Oh, you lose two.
The bears with the early aggression.
Get one first. You got one left. You get one die.
Which stays its normal value because of the blanket effects.
Right, so
North Africa's been claimed.
I get a resource card?
At the end of your turn?
At the end of my turn.
For combat or because?
For combat.
Before the plane. Before he took it there or Tora.
That's fine. People just don't understand mutants. They've just misunderstood. They're peaceful creatures. They're just.
Africa has been secured in the name of the Enclave of the Bear.
Okay, moving on.
Soon it will
Captain, be. I see something over the ridge.
You see a bunch of half-naked painted dudes on bears off in the air, like Tusken Raiders.
Is that bear cavalry? Wait a second, let me see those.
Holy shit, it is.
They're like
And soon,
we should probably steer clear away from
this. It's like, then you say, Lieutenant, I owe you a Coke.
And soon, that continent shall be named Kashyyyk.
Kashyyyk.
And I'm gonna...
It's like, Sergeant, it seems like we...
Or that or Bear-to-ween.
Bear-to-ween. Oh, I like that.
I'm assuming that your forces are
going to be moving into... Yep. And then I pick a resource card.
I'm just going to pick a random one. Can I pick one at the top of the stat?
Or do I have to pick one of the ones that's been drawn?
I believe you have to pull one that's been drawn.
That's also how
I'll just use Egypt.
If you attack and conquer at least one territory on your turn, then you're eligible to draw a resource card. Let's see. Look at the face up ones on the sideboard, pick which one you want. Let's see here. If you control one or more territories shown on the cards, then you must select one of the cards with a territory you control on
and
it.
I control Egypt.
Yeah, so. Congratulations. And you get Northern Europe slides down.
No, he gets the card instead of the coin.
Yeah, right. Northern Europe slides down.
So if that's an even coin production, it is, so that reveals an event card.
That's what you read it or you want to?
Go for it.
Okay.
Control the people. Whomever has the largest population either gains 5 troops in one city he controls or may make an immediate maneuver.
I believe that is me. Because I have 5 population.
Population is just from cities or is it from territories as well?
If it's from territories, I have 7 to Josh's 6.
It's actually like cities by the looks of it.
I don't know what the pop is.
So I have 3. I have 5, yep. 1, 2, 1. So I gain 5 troops.
Population is also, I think, is also the continent bonus.
Like, how do you count population?
Yeah, that's my
population.
Population. As you play war games, cities will be founded, cities, Your population is the sum of all cities you control. If you control 1 major city and 2 minor cities, your population is 4, 2 plus 1 plus 1. So it's only cities.
Okay.
So that's me with 5 because I have 2 major cities.
Thanks, Rob.
So I gain 5 troops instead?
5 troops, or you can make an immediate maneuver.
I'll take 5 troops because I'm about to also get reinforcements. I want them in. So.
I also feel like combat's about to start happening over there.
Possibly. I don't know.
Then
I only have 10 as my total for pops and territories, so I still only get 3 for the start of my turn from population and territories. But I also get 2 more from the Australian continent bonus.
Aussie.
Oi, oi, oi. Would you like to be left alone and finish out the mutants?
Hold on.
Because I'll make an armistice line.
I'm reading. Yes.
Okay.
Either I could basically immediately slap Joe in the face and we can escalate, or I could work with him. I'll work with him.
We'll make an armistice line. India, I'll leave completely...
How ironic. A nuclear armistice in India.
Point being, I won't take anything in India. I might be in Afghanistan. I have to make counts.
That's cool. That shit's going to change hands so many times. It's not even funny, dude. You know that.
He's right there in Europe. want to leave. First off, I want to exchange these 3 for this 3 token because it just makes life a little easier and when I get to reinforcements. I'd like a resource card, so I'm going to hate to say it, but I'm going to try and kick you out of Kuppenberg for a turn.
Motherfucking Kuppenberg.
Defense, watch your roll. Bunch of 6s, it'll be...
Yeah, pretty dang good. Oof.
Yes!
Oof.
Reminds me of a song.
I'll move them in there.
Son of a bitch. Give me a drink.
Get a little Gutenberg. How do you get a resource? Card. Oh, yeah, combat.
Mm-hmm. Take a territory through combat, yes.
Doo-doo.
Or by playing the faction we didn't pick.
Yeah. Is it still the thing is once you get three resource cards, you trade them in for more troops? Or?
There's a chart.
Yeah.
Chart here. You can have as many gold coins or worth of cards as you want.
Or turn in four resource cards flat out for one star.
So basically, I need two coins to cash in for two troops, right?
Right.
Yeah.
But you can also save up for 30 troops. Has happened before.
Yeah, it is now.
God, I have to do counting, math.
I'll do it faster.
Well, move those boys into your wall. We'll just switch that around. On my reinforce, I'll bring
these guys in the paddle room
to
stomping their big old clumsy feet all over.
I do control URL. I have to pick URL.
You say, recently beat Fallout 4 going with the Brotherhood of Steel. Dicks, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Big old dicks. But they give you the coolest tech in the game. So yeah.
It's pretty sweet.
You are the best of us, so have a chat back.
At the start of your turn, mm-hmm. Greenland, have a nuclear accident.
What happens when the biohazard sticker for normal players?
Normal players lose one troop.
You get a bonus in biohazard areas, don't you?
Yeah, yes. Instead of reverse, so if you lose a troop, I gain a troop.
Now you only lose a troop at the end of your turn.
Okay. Which means he can actually lose his continent bonus if he's not careful.
What is who are the bringers of nuclear fire? What
Continent Industries. Con Industries. They're the ones who basically cause the nuke in the
Now, you can't put multiple stars in one location, can
no.
you?
No. It is one scar per location. Unless you remove a scar. And you can do that as a victory condition.
But, like, so if I place, like, if, for instance, if I placed a biohazard symbol on one of your territories, you would not lose the dude at the end of the turn, would you?
No.
He'd gain one. He'd actually gain people.
Yeah.
But basically, mercenaries for us is how he treats biohazards. Biohazards for us is how he treats mercenaries.
Should I have not gained a troop there, then? When you control it.
Oh. Yeah, you... Well, if it's at the end of the turn, then yes, you would have.
Okay.
Then yes, there should actually be another.
So yes,
yeah. And it adds directly to that territory, not anywhere in your control.
Does that count as biohazard?
No.
Okay.
It's got its own rules.
That has its own rules of mega death for everybody but you.
What are mercenary star effects?
Nobody has placed a mercenary star on the board yet. But mercenaries are basically we would gain troops. I like mercenaries. I gain an extra troop from every mercenary location. Because I'm convincing, damn it. Now I'm worried about the whole massive con industries for it.
Holy balls. Right.
I need a card, so.
Oh, yeah. Apparently, Con Industries wants their homeland back. Or just a lot more territory. Bit of column A, bit of column B.
Saw that coming. Damn, the spread is real. Alright, defend.
Here's your attack, guys.
Damn. Me and Trav had a good battle out over there. He had like 30 plus troops get knocked, like not 30, no, he got like 12 troops knocked out by one guy. I was like, what? I died. Explain it out.
You have your choice of Alaska or Northwest Territory. I wonder what you're going to pick. And the card is odd.
Argentina.
All right, mutants. Gain from territories plus population, you gain an extra 2 for having New Madagascar, and then an additional 1 because you're the one who named it New Madagascar.
So 6
total. Cool.
Six dudes, hold on to trash trucks in
Brazil. Not political commentary in the league.
Yeah. Bring it, North Africa.
Yep.
Now it's one of those, do I stay or do I go?
Do I stay or do I go?
Yep, alright. Let's do it. I get plus 1 on my highs because I have a bunker, right?
Yep.
Doesn't help when I roll like that. Well,
I had a 4, 1, and a 1.
I got a, so a 4 and a 3, one. So we each lose 1.
That turns into me.
Yeah.
And I assume you would want to go and yeah. Turn 3? Yeah.
Oh, well, there's a 6.
Yeah.
You were Mongolia, I believe this is the Dirt Bridge.
Yes, I was.
Alrighty then. There's a trash truck in North Africa.
Clean up the riffraff that was there.
The and riffraff.
Any reinforcements you want to do?
Move from one to one.
Along a connected route.
What do you mean?
No, like, if I severed his supply line in Mongolia, he couldn't reinforce into China.
Oh, why can't I reinforce either?
Because
you can only move from one territory.
You can't.
So you
can't
move from multiple.
You can just go from one to one.
Ah.
Or from one to one.
But this is why I still have 3 folks in Copia.
I couldn't
bring my folks up to Copia. And from
you can move as many troops as you want from a territory to a territory, as long as at least one stays behind.
Mm-hmm. And end of your turn, you get an extra deal on Argentina.
Yep.
And you pull the Argentina card or the Peru card. Your choice, you have to pull one or the other. You don't have any other options.
Why do I take the Argentina? Because I've won in that.
You have to take of territories you control. So you had the choice between either the South America.
But with that said, getting cards is strictly better than getting coins because you have the potential chance to go and get stars off of cards.
Winning the game.
Winning, yeah.
Because right now you have no stars.
That's how bad was?
No, you don't.
There's about house in Greenland now.
Oh, yeah, so you don't remove it, you lose your star.
Did you remove a troop from Greenland at the end of the
game? Okay.
It's my thing.
Yep.
I got a scrap card.
So
yeah,
I just get 3, right?
Yes.
How do you go if it's a mercenary? Because I have like a little guy with a gun.
That's the mercenary scar. And there, as I said, there's not one on here yet. Wait, you're placing your reinforcements?
Yes.
And why did you place somebody in Western Europe? I mean, that's fine. It's just...
Little armed at one of your tactics when attacking HQ.
Yeah, too bad. Scary. Winning HQs isn't the victory condition this game.
I mean, HQ is a star.
Yeah. It's still a star.
Yeah.
Like, is the mission, does that only affect at the end of the game?
No, it's as soon as somebody can achieve that.
Yeah.
That's 6 cities. Not 6 population, that's 6 cities. Otherwise, I would have scored that.
So we're just not 6 cities?
No.
Yes.
There's not that many cities on the board.
Oh, these are cities.
Yeah.
Yes.
Not territories.
All the rules.
Shindigs and boot nannies.
All your fancy rules.
I'm just gonna reinforce. That's it.
What does the one mean?
It's one population worth. It's a minor city. the two population of major cities, and those are places that he can actually put his HQ.
All right, so my turn?
Yep. Those mutants do not like you.
I think that's okay. I don't think the bears like the mutants either.
Yeah.
There's a mutual hate that, you know, is produced when you have two...
Because,
Two beings that are mutated in some way.
And both each being feels that they are the superior mutated life form.
And once again, these guys are chill, man.
Well, you were mutated, we were engineered. Oh my god, I have a bunch of eugenicists. That's
and I'm in a bunker.
Yeah, but so you have a 7 and a 1.
Yeah. Well, it can't go any higher than a 6. It just, it ignores a minus 1. If there was 1.
So,
1 and 1.
1 and 1. This is why you don't clean up 3 troops if you can. Six and a 1 versus a 6 so and a 5. So 1-1.
1-1.
The bears are taking these casualties in stride.
2. Massive 2.
4. And a 4. Yeah. Well, 3 and a 4. Yeah. The bears have reconquered.
That's fine.
I'm going to reinforce. I don't own any of
those. I
still
have
North Africa.
I have a whole lot of
coins.
And Peru gets this card. No, you don't get the card.
Yeah, I'll take a coin.
You get a coin, and then Peru is discarded, and we go and ship them down.
Okay. Apparently, you remember rules better than I do.
Why is Peru discarded? Because it's the last one in line.
Oh, okay.
But why did you get a coin?
And you can only cash in coins at the beginning of your.
Because he doesn't actually control any of the territories. They're visible.
So you can't get
Peru goes into the discard pile there, and then he wins.
No, you can't get any of these. I mean, you don't have a choice between the two, that's what I'm asking.
Apparently not.
Okay.
If he's remembering the rules right, and I would trust his memory better than mine.
I don't know if he picked the card first, or if the card, you know, comes out first, but...
No, I was just wondering if it wasn't a territory that you... It's otherwise, you must draw one of the face-up coin cards. So either you control one and you take it, or you take a coin.
Take a coin, okay.
Let's see here. At the end of your turn, when you draw a resource card, you may draw a face-up card containing a territory in your homeland, even if you don't control that territory.
Go for it, yeah.
But anyway.
I think that means him with any South American country, but he started there, so it's not going to matter.
All right, so the event card is... Control the people. Whoever has the largest population either gains 5 troops in one city he controls or makes an immediate maneuver.
Again?
He shuffled.
He did.
He shuffled poorly.
That or there's just that many copies of this card.
Alright, now let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Because you took one territory to prevent me from getting an additional troop. So I get 4 from population and territories, and then an additional 2 from Australia for a total of 6 troops.
I love the fact that we have...
You appear to have your hands full, but I'm honoring our deal.
Okay, fair enough.
The only request,
may
I take India? Will that offend you?
It should offend you. It's India.
All right, Gandhi.
I've seen that Bollywood movie.
If that will help you reinforce this border of Asia, go ahead.
It will make me feel less...
Trapped.
Do I desperately want 2 extra troops now? Alright, first up is India. Then from India, we're going into China. So,
dude.
6 is like it ain't nothing.
Ain't no thing.
From China, we're going into. Mongolia. Which again.
Yeah, Mongolia! How dare you try to take down my shitty wall?
A 6 and 10.
From Mongolia. You'll send a dude into Siberia. two dudes into Irkutsk, one of which shall trample into Yakutsk, a division into Japan, and from Japan to, what is this, Kamchatka.
I assume you're going to leave a dude in Japan?
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Have to.
Oh. Yeah. Defender always wins ties, so that's a dude.
That's another dude.
Hold on. It's more dudes than I was planning to lose in Kamchatka.
I mean, I've lost as many dudes
actually,
so far.
Technically,
I've lost two dudes also. Whatever.
I'm more okay with that simply because you have to put your earned troops there, and there may be shenanigans.
Shenanigans?
No, there's going to be shenanigans.
I'll hold on down in Japan.
Shenanigans are a thing in this game.
Reinforcements, or what? Restructuring, whatever. I'm ending my turn. I'm going to get a coin card because I can't draw South Africa, Greenland, Alberta, or Northern Europe. Though I could have invaded for Northern Europe, and I probably should have for two coins. I'm going to break up the Ural.
Is this what the kind of coins they're worth, or like you can cash them in for coins? Or
is yeah,
that... it's how many coins that card is worth.
And that gets replaced by one troop there. And no. All right, Trav, ruined my day. Actually, I'm getting a sign that we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, Trav is probably going to break all sorts of shit because he still has a 5-troop bonus from the entire North American continent.
If I even think so, that's...
That's mine.
And we're back after a bloodbath of Trav taking everything and Justin being his patsy once again and spending a missile on Trav's behalf.
There. Oh, did you take your one dude off Alaska?
I just went and killed off
it's
my...
Called, hey, Will, you want to be it's relevant? Keep him from a continent bonus.
Get my one card. These move down.
It's odd. Okay.
So you still get to play that because you got troops, right? You still can...
I'm still in the game.
Oh, yeah. He'll still get three troops.
If I got completely wiped out, I'd still be able to respawn in Western Europe.
I gotcha. Do you just take his... base off the map?
No.
It's his control, so he counts as having a star for purposes of a victory count. But it doesn't...
Oh, and move. As soon as I get a card, I get a missile power, right?
As soon as you get a... Yeah, you get to choose the first missile power.
Sweet.
Does the, does that base now count plus one for him, too, since he owns it?
It's not a population.
No, plus one on his die roll.
No.
Okay.
That is a faction power, not an HQ power. My faction power says my HQ is treated as fortified when I defend it. Makes sense. Diamond cannon technology will not work for the heathens who use inferior parts of their mechs. We will have our revenge!
Alright. This one seems appropriate for Khan Industries. So they can go and spend a missile to go and place... At the start of their turn, they can spend a missile to place 2 troops on every HQ they control.
Wow, that's good.
Oh, God.
That's real good.
Khan Industries is becoming this destructive beast of ridiculousness when Trav has them.
Ridiculous.
All right.
So I get a total of 5 people, is that correct?
6.
6. You get the naming bonus from me.
Because this is your continent.
All right,
your homeland.
Push these people in there.
Your tank does, sir.
Where's the other?
Oh. Okay. Fair enough.
All right. So 1-1.
No, I'm spending 3 on them. That's it.
That's 3 sixes.
As part of my agreement.
Y'all are so daffy for your agreement.
Patsy, right there. That's his fault.
I mean, you and him were all in on
I
agreement. Have
yet to see I know.
We can't say anything.
You two are
fine. Oh, you totally did.
Just as much
yeah,
as
you
are.
Totally there's did. There's a difference. We're just going, hey, we ain't going to backstab each other yet. You're going in on a nuclear arms agreement because you're the only 2 missile powers.
Is missile just a reroll, or do you make
missiles
whatever you want?
Missiles turn any die roll... into a 6.
Okay.
So you target a die roll.
Okay.
So we have a box to open. I'm excited about that.
So technically, Trav could have done 3 missiles, 2 on Justin, 1 on Josh, to make him lead more forces and still
could have, but Justin could also go and conquer most of my territory too.
Yeah.
Which I wonder why he doesn't.
He's got troop left.
Yeah.
Roll that roll six, or five. Bunker.
Yeah, no.
Alright.
Open when three missiles are used on the same combat roll.
Yes.
That's aliens, I believe. But they're not helping
out. I hope so.
Yeah.
God, there's a new faction.
That'd be awesome.
You haven't even gotten real mutants yet. You're like, I want to see the new faction.
But they're cool, I think.
I like the mutants, yeah. I wouldn't mind.
Aliens! Them. Oh, God. Aliens have, like the mutants, a permanent victory condition modifier. If they control every city on the board, they automatically have two of their four stars needed to win.
That's
tricky.
When recruiting, you get two extra troops if you control Alien Island and one extra troop for each ruin you control. And you do not lose troops when expanding into empty cities.
Wait, what? So does that mean you don't have to leave someone behind?
I'm not sure.
These are the new.
That is definitely.
We get new scars, which wouldn't take effect. Events, which probably don't take effect, because I don't think we.
I don't think that would happen in the middle of a game.
Yeah. No. But anyway, we have unlocked new.
You
have the rest of your turn to go. Would you like to take over the rest after?
I'm contemplating the idea.
Yeah. We'll just have to see who gets to go in place where. Alien Island.
That's with you. I'm looking through here to see because most of the War Progresses cards are in here. But the plastic is just not opening nicely. I'm trying not to bend card corners.
I don't know if I want to steamroll Africa or if I just want to.
Steamroll North America?
You've been very passive aggressive. You know that, right?
That would be pretty hard.
Yeah.
With the number of troops.
Yo, I got this.
All right, do it then. Do it. I ain't gonna stop you. Obviously.
Thank you.
You could take Egypt.
Yes, sir.
Egypt also would give you one more population from Ursaheim.
That's the biggest thing, but then he would just take his bears and they'll walk their constipated.
You have reinforcements you can bring from Argentina.
Or from Venezuela.
I don't recommend that, because that's just going to give Trav the game.
I have certain embassy.
Good. Oh, Venezuela. Those are scar cards. That's why they're here.
Six. You have other scarecrows over there.
Yep.
And those Mike.
Supposed to go easy on me.
I think that's a seven.
Damn. Bad roll there. Oh, come on. Wait, you had one person in the territory.
He's got two.
Oh, yeah.
Two more here. But...
Okay, well, so. He did all right.
Oh, that's what ruins are.
Ruined cities.
Reinforce.
More that
can that be? Can I do it?
Yeah. And then
end of turn. Hand me those scars back.
Okay. Oh,
they're actually relevant for every other faction.
Zahara, doesn't he have to be connected to the territory to reinforce? Or?
As long as he has one contiguous route.
Okay.
He does.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
And that'd be my turn, guys.
Yeah. We'll handle that on the future game.
All right. Well,
so I just get brewed.
Yep.
Okay.
Durable.
It's all right. This is where he plays all Paul Ellering from NXT. The page has been written. The plan is in effect. The authors of William Harrison are the answer.
I still don't know how in the world they got him to come back.
I still can't believe that the match at the end of the Duddy tournament was basically a freaking toy shell out. With the crash cage and stuff.
Well, it's
still a good match.
It's a riff on a very classic gimmick. The idea of suspending the manager above the ring and cage. That's a time-honored thing.
I will have to say, though, the main event of the first episode of 205 Live was a freaking barn burner between Brian Kendrick and Rick Swann. I mean, it was awesome.
Didn't they put the belt on Swann?
Yeah, and he won by three vicious ass hook kicks to like Kendrick's face.
Hey, Josh,
yo,
you're up, and North America remains untouched, which is going to cost everybody.
Not a whole lot I can do about it.
You didn't want to attack Joe? I mean, everybody's picking on Joe.
I actually have a fairly defensive border on him.
I'm
going
to trade in two.
Or two. Honestly, don't have to take all your spaces. I can just save back the one that one territory.
Yeah.
But get that. I'm not going to right now.
Just get that little book.
Will is playing some sort of game and we don't know what. The bears and the mutants going
to never win. Fucking guess.
Throw up there.
God, because I've seen the same
by roll.
You have a three. A four.
It
three.
Wouldn't matter. Lost two regardless.
Dun dun dun. Didn't
one
year old.
So I'm going to try something on my turn.
Yeah,
I know.
Okay.
Wait.
Actually, if you
roll
a
you roll
six,
you still win.
Yeah.
No,
it's a bunker.
It's a bunker.
It's bunker, yeah.
Out.
So,
yeah. If it weren't for the bunker,
you
still have a shot.
You were
oh.
Crunch.
Get wrecked, child.
A grizzly just kind of put the head of that mutant in his mouth.
You up again, dog. I'm down. I get a bunker bonus, right?
The bunker bonus and his attack bonus cancel.
So it's one.
So basically, it's
one.
No, because the bunker goes on the high.
Oh, and the his goes on the lowest, right?
Yeah.
So
I got a five.
So
a
five.
One and one.
Yeah,
it's one and one.
Those rascals.
Six.
So
and
four.
One and
one.
Ooh, one and one.
Yeah,
one and
yeah. Vicious.
Savage.
Don't hold this shit. It's so weird.
Do
it.
Two
eagles.
You got it.
It's a tie.
Yep.
One die. One on one.
But you have a three.
Right. He had a two.
He had a two.
On a bunker.
Correct, but you
oh,
are...
Oh, right,
yeah.
You only had one die.
Yeah.
Attacking as a bear, right?
Yeah.
Which is...
Correction.
Now, is that...
No, that's only on the first territory you attack during your turn.
Okay.
So,
there's already lost two troops by the way as well.
Yeah.
Well, the others weren't.
Oh,
nailed
crunch.
It.
Yeah.
The bears. Might I suggest moving a guy up to your HQ when he inevitably swarms through me and into you?
I'm going to be completely honest with you. Next round, I'm probably going to butt-fuck North Africa again.
Probably. The fact is you should have done it like 8 turns ago. Instead of getting into yourself in a position where you could be eliminated by Trav.
Probably shouldn't have said that.
Well, it's pretty obvious, actually.
Yeah, I mean, it was. We have like an agreement across the table just to constantly fight over North Africa. Like it's just
it's a thing.
It's a political thing. My turn.
North Africa is
South Africa.
The new Middle East.
It is the new Middle East.
See,
well,
now
we
to
don't
Jerusalem.
Want that mission. To
it's
pop
a
up.
North African.
That, God, I wish we would name it Jerusalem.
The next
Jerusalem,
New Jerusalem.
Not
because
it's part
of Jerusalem.
No. Here's your new event.
Jerusalem?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey. Fallout. Roll one die for each territory connected to the Fallout by land. Remove that many troops from that territory.
No, unless they are mutants?
No. And then destroy this card.
Fallout.
Lose them all.
Bang. Yes!
Okay,
Peru, you roll for territory.
You gotta do Peru. And
what the fuck just happened?
Brazil.
Fallout just happens.
Peru, lose them all.
That's Brazil.
Sure, and he's not gonna be able to not.
And you can't not lose anybody in Peru.
What about the Fallout Square itself?
The Fallout Square itself is its only territory is connected.
Nuclear
to the
all of a sudden, trap me not with this game. With
and.
Destroy that car.
And Fallout
you would
is
think,
destroyed.
You would think it wouldn't affect the mutants, though, considering they live in it. Like,
they don't lose half their troops every turn from a Fallout Square, as far as I remember.
Understand.
This is that a mutant event card?
It doesn't say mutant on it.
Okay.
It's just red. So.
Because they don't lose troops from Fallout Terror territory and mutant event cards.
Okay. Which that's would that not be? Oh, well, that's
double checking. To be fair.
So again, zombies die from giant explosions too.
Well, to be fair, when you got too much radiation, your mutants turn into like mindless feral mutants.
Yeah, but at least they still
all right.
Pop around.
So, yeah.
To a certain extent, and then
gonna see if there's another copy of that card.
I think you
say
certain amounts of radiation.
Well, I'm gonna see if there's a commonality.
Well,
those mutants.
Can I see the alien cards?
They shouldn't have anything mutant specific.
I know, but the top border of the card will let me know if what I'm trying to figure out. Yes, it was a mutant event card.
So you get your one back in Peru and
you're
on two in Brazil?
Yes.
I'm gonna put that right there.
So yeah, it fucked Trav over nicely.
We still have an agreement though, so I'm not gonna go.
It happens.
Yeah.
Alright, so I will get three from normal reinforced because I think I'm also drop below population.
Is pretty shit though.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's wrong.
I'm gonna cash in 3 points. To get an extra fortress.
Those mutants though.
Those mutants though.
Those mutants though.
Mongolia.
Yes.
Oh, you guys are fighting
China.
Oh, yeah. I would like my H2 back, yes. I would like to make it harder for him to
That's
win.
That's going
to
be a hell of a challenge, buddy.
That's your level.
That's awesome. I have 30
so
definitely.
Much blood in China.
Yeah.
This poor Chinese
brings new meaning to the word rape China.
How about get another missile?
Next game.
Winning games
winning
or
game?
Completing certain missions. We'll get a new.
Or playing as communists.
When the mutants are also playing.
Oh, they'll be in play.
The mutants are gonna stay as long as.
All right, we're gonna try for Southeast Asia.
That are aliens. Are aliens up next?
Again, faction drafts.
Yeah, I know.
One
faction.
On one.
Boom.
Boom shakalaka, they told me.
He's out of missiles now, thankfully.
Yep, you're right.
That's all I'm asking. How can I get another
missile? One.
Gotta be able to help out somehow.
I'm gonna place that with some troops instead. I still have numerical advantage somehow.
Damn, we got another 6.
That's
fucking
that's
two.
No, that's two.
For you.
Great brutal.
I'm not stopping.
Can't stop.
Oh, deuces!
God, you could. That just sucks. Snake eyes.
No, what sucks is you spent a missile for Trav and are not going to capitalize on it.
Hey, he spent missiles on me too, and he didn't capitalize on it.
Yep.
No, he effectively forced you to overextend, make both you and the pairs weaker. Yeah. Reinforcements. There will be a lot of blood spilled in China. I wanted to at least bunker up in Southeast Asia, if not Indonesia, but I guess I can't get that far.
This game is going exactly how I wanted it to.
What, Coop winning?
No, it just be
by a landslide?
Constant bloodshed.
All right, Coop.
So
you
I
get...
have 20... population between all the cities and stuff, and then I get an extra 2 from Australia. So
yeah,
20,
he does
so
have 20.
20
is 6 troops
so
plus games. Another 2.
And then one, and then Con Industries, I get 1 on each.
So doing the Con Industries,
quarters,
and then 20. This is why I want to take my H2 back. Rip game. Trav wins. Potentially.
I'll do it there.
I don't know, man. People might be pulling stars out of nowhere.
No?
I don't know.
I'll put a sacrificial lamb there.
I have a feeling you're going to.
He's just one shot at getting the mission done.
Yeah?
What is it?
He has to find one more city.
Oh, okay.
know where he's
at. Yeah, no, he has a route to the city I have from you earlier, and that would mean he gets a star from that.
I mean, there's no good routes to a city right now.
He's going to go through three of mine one way or another. But ironically enough, if you go Middle East to cap his HQ and then Kupenberg, you can win with on that turn.
I could, but I don't think I'm going to roll that well.
So. What's that combat power you have over here? Did you get that?
If I get eliminate, I'll get a one.
It's the only faction that doesn't have that one.
Two of my power.
Idiot that.
I have green light. I'll take green light. And then troop dies. Troop dies. And reinforcements.
Nova?
All right, Justin.
I got scared.
I'm too surprised, but to be honest.
I will take my...
I took my homeland back.
I'll take my two garbage trucks. And I'm going to put them in Brazil.
Yep.
So they can drive right on over to North Africa.
Why? Because it's actually not like it would be that hard for him to actually go... Put that one dude there. I was wondering if he's
going to hurt. Would you please deny him five extra troops?
Yeah.
He's getting quite a number of them.
I mean,
now.
Based on his trait, it would not be hard for him to go and actually conquer North America because he gets to re-roll ones against me.
But I've also made a treaty. And I'm a man of my word. And
bullshit, you are!
He is a mutant.
The other three games have said otherwise.
And until that treaty is broken, damn it.
You are a man of your word, which means you are bad at risk.
Yeah.
That has been serving as Travis Patsy since day one. No, you're not. You backstabbed me when we had an agreement in game two. Yeah. Bullshit, man, his word.
And he won that game. Says
it
right here.
Yeah, why doesn't he want to win this game and deny you an extra,
like
seven
I said,
troops?
I never play with the intention of winning. I simply play to do what I want to do.
You play this game more by listening to what Trav says than anything else.
No, actually, I think at this point he just really wants North Africa. He's just fixated.
Oh, no, I'm getting it. That's his personal win condition, but there's nothing saying you can't take South America.
He wants Zeon.
Or Central America.
Oh, and it would...
Oh, yeah, and deny you five troops.
You could
possibly.
I would prefer Cheeseburg back, but that's just so far away.
We could get there.
You could get there.
I mean, dice rolls happen.
So. I've effectively been eliminated from this game. It will cost them in blood, but I've effectively been eliminated from this game.
Even Will, with your 14 extra troops.
What 14 extra troops?
The ones I worked really, really hard to kill.
Oh, no, that wasn't 14, though. That was...
You got 10 from those events.
Oh, yeah.
How many does he get next round?
A lot. He gets, seven from Pops and Territory, and an additional five from North America, and an additional two from Australia.
I mean,
I am.
Oh.
I mean, I suspect I'm going to lose a good bit of that.
I hope it's...
Other than just Australia, I suspect that's the only thing
that will
survive
is,
this.
The real fact here is that me and Trav both understand that eventually I'm going to move into North America.
Yeah. I'm arguing that Shmi now...
Oh, yes, I'm sure he's going to win the game before you move into North America.
You're taking too long. He's going to have an overwhelming troop advantage. Get used to this.
Oh, you guys are so worried.
It's like it's part of the game, and you've achieved your personal victory.
Actually, I love how we have this rather pretty mellow race war in North Africa. All right, you come in, and then I'll attack back.
Yeah, we'll just keep this going. The question is, if I keep pushing in, about how far can I poke into your territory?
How far can you poke the bear before the bear pokes back?
If only you had selected the double six power of automatically taking territory, then you'd have a chance against Trav.
I don't know.
I mean, Will could have gone and stopped me at any point in time if he
one.
Well, big
one
thing.
Will's playing his own long con game.
With that said, I've let Will go and sit there completely undisturbed the entire game. So.
Actually, yeah, because I was the pity.
Me and you have both kind of let Will do his thing.
Yeah. I took the one C because I could get an extra 2 pop out of that. That was it.
Oh, man. I'm so tempted because Africa's now just looking tastier. I got a little bit of North Africa in me. There's a couple parties.
Oh, my God. Stop tinkering and do something.
This game should not take an hour and a half for one turn.
Yeah.
Crunch.
Yeah.
For the hell of it, go ahead and move 3 right there.
I want a 4 and I have no clue where that die went.
Well, I got a 2,
so it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter anyway. Yeah.
And then,
reinforce some Argentina. Control none of those cards, take a coin, the China card gets burned, ironically. Oh no! Actually, the China card should have been mine. I actually earned that one. Oh. I screwed up.
Look at you.
I'll take a
failure.
Must I take any card?
Well, it meant we would have had an event earlier.
When can we turn in this stuff? Only at the beginning of
event. Start your turn.
It's event.
Join the cause. Whomever has the largest population.
Okay.
Either receives 3 troops that can be placed into one or more city territories he controls, or may choose a new mission from the mission deck to replace the current one, discarding the current mission and then reshuffling the deck.
That would be you, Drug.
So I can put 3 dudes into a city?
Or yes.
You can change the current mission. Change the current mission, I dare you.
It's or and.
Or.
So get 3 troops there, or you change.
Who would have guessed he would have picked the troops?
Alright, Will gets to continue his turn.
Well, start his turn.
Or sorry, start his turn. Yeah. Die Mechanicer will die hard.
With a vengeance.
Because you are defending, that now becomes, 4?
5.
It was 6.
That was a 6 that I rolled.
6? Okay. So
ammo shortage?
Yep.
Kupenberg has critical ammo shortages. Russia goes, what, really?
Europe, super indefensible.
Yeah, I think you took it that time. I rolled a 1.
Yep.
A 0?
Good job on that 0.
And this is Will's first combat rolls.
Yes.
Yes.
And he'll get a 2 coin card in skin and aging.
He will.
Mm-hmm. Son of a gun.
Good. That's all I wanted to do.
Like a beast.
No.
Am I going to need those? Cash in.
Or 2 more dudes?
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Who's got a problem?
So you get 5 total?
I do, but at the same time, William, I basically left you alone the entire game, and I am not going to leave you alone the entire game. You're getting like a top of the game. Or at this point, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Let's say, if you leave me alone, I won't fuck with anything else in Africa.
No, it's too late for that. That sounded hollow to you too.
Defend yourself!
I got a 6, right? Bunker.
A 6 and a 0, yep.
My, it's looking mighty tasty for you to roll through.
5 and 0.
Well, 5 and 1. It's almost
1 and 1.
Oh.
3.
Gone. 4.
Crunch.
You want to take that one back too?
So, yeah, I'd rather.
You want to take that? Like that?
Yeah, I'd rather take that first.
Oh, boy. Okay, let's see.
4 and 3. Versus 4 and 4. 1 and 1. You have still have 3 trips.
5 and 3.
No, crunch.
Both of them. Right?
Yep.
Yep.
2-man attack squad in North Africa.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dig it.
Oh yeah, dig it.
3.
Dig it.
3 and 3. So I lose a troop, right?
Nope.
No.
Oh, okay. I lose a troop.
Yep. You guys lose the tie. So 1-on-1.
No. Okay, yeah.
North Africa stays where it belongs!
Should have went into Europe, man.
Alright.
You. It was the only territory that really mattered, let's be honest. North
so
Africa
you
is.
Get a coin?
You do get a coin.
And Siberia gets burned.
Yep. I played the exact
game. We get an event. Maybe one that will help me catch up.
I played the exact game that I wanted to.
Alright. I'm going into Irkutsk.
Yes.
Because I'm going to want a card. And I'll bleed you a troop and a territory.
Did you get you 3?
Yeah. Oh. I put them all in Irkutsk so I can attack him with 3.
Come
on. 3.
You against a foe.
And they flying the foe folk and see foe folk.
I'm open to deals and trade agreements.
Well, that's quite obvious at this
point. I'm done. I control none of those. So, Indonesia gets burned. I get a coin card.
Indonesia.
Southern Europe. No events.
Hey.
Had that game like I don't just see.
You need to keep track of that.
You did. You did.
Because you moved him off and then you're. Chad's going to get a boatload of troops.
22 population, so that makes 7. And then I get 7 from
continent bonuses.
From continent bonuses.
Plus you're 1 on each.
And then I get 1 on each HQ.
So a lot. The sacrificial lamb, as they say.
As they say.
So, I mean,
so apparently no one's going to Australia, is what I see.
Apparently
there's an embargo.
Oh no! This is why I moved everybody into Afghanistan. I'm making them take as long as possible.
Way that you could win this game more quickly?
Yeah, I have to take 1, 2, 3,
there's
4,
one.
4 territories.
Because I would say, please do so.
Yes, I have to take 4
territories. Because this game is garbage.
3, 4.
I mean, this round is garbage.
This is pretty
why? Short. Patsy, that's
why.
Well,
I need to all this in the Ural. I'm going to dodge it after this thing.
We are just showing the importance of agreements early on in the game.
Nope, that dies. I consciously made an effort to have minimum possible roadblocks. That's why I congregated everybody in Afghanistan instead of having to go through a territory with 3.
4.
Well, no, he's got an ammo shortage. It's hard for him to defend it.
You lose 2.
I lose 2.
6 and 4 against ammo shortage hits the highest die or lowest die?
It's right up there.
Ammo shortage is from the highest die. So you have
3. So you lose 2 guys.
And then going into
Mike, when they had the whole thing in the crossover where Ragman's like, oh, it's
and
from the Torah.
And look at Roger.
This week on Jews in Space.
Oh my gosh.
All right. Oh.
Someone else is going after the
it's
Bears.
It's come down to this, huh?
Yep.
6 and 3.
Okay.
That's 2.
Yup. All
right. That's it. I stop there. Four stars. So.
Yeah. Do you?
He wins this.
One submission. Two from two opposing HQs.
And one for my own HQ.
Nope.
You know, you don't have the immediate starting star anymore.
Once I don't you think you get one for a holding your HQ.
After you check. Win a game, I don't think you get it anymore.
I'll check.
You get a missile instead of the star.
I mean, if not, I'm going back up to Scandinavia, so.
You could just, like, roll all the way through to the mutants if you want to.
Nah.
That'd be a lot further. Yeah, have a chance of failing.
But he gets to leave blood in just a trail.
Through Africa. Well, I succeeded on my personal mission for game one.
I want nothing to do with this continent right here. There is so much blood in this continent.
Enclave of the Bear, you have failed me for the last time. I'm going to try the freaking Neo-Britain thing next game.
My personal victory has already been accomplished.
I suppose just in case, I'm going to start rolling these dice.
Yeah, go ahead.
Dice just in case. So, Will, defend yourself.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, like, as long as North Africa ends the game in my hands, I have 1-1.
1-1.
Every HQ on the board is a star.
Okay.
Yeah, never mind. So, fuck it.
So yet again, Trav adds his name to his board, which means he has to find himself at his own damn pen because I don't think I have one in the box.
Missions for the aliens, but we'll have the war progresses to read out what starts. Am I doing it in order? They have been living among us. The faction about to place. Is the alien collaborating?
I suspect we should have done that during the game.
No. I actually suspect that the boxes got switched around because this says the faction about to place 30 plus troops is the alien collaborator and has been working with an alien race in an attempt to conquer the planet.
Fact.
That was you regardless.
Uh-huh.
Alien collaborator. Add 1 to your resource total when turning in cards. Lose 2 extra troops when expanding into empty cities. Apparently we forgot that expanding into an empty city costs you an extra troop. The alien collaborator also places the alien island sticker on the next card, as in from these, onto any ocean and places both sea line start stickers onto 2 different territories that have borders touching an ocean. Connect each sea line start stickers to different sea line on an alien island using a pen. These territories are now connected to the alien island. Trav? Either way, you basically opened both boxes anyway. You're the one who had it. That's if you need to reread how to do that.
Alien Island.
I didn't help with any of that, though.
Oh. This game would have been over a lot sooner. This actually would have started for this game only. For this game only, the alien collaborator and the aliens are one faction, and their troops can be intermixed. The alien collaborator places the 30-plus troops he's getting onto the alien island, along with 10 alien troops. Yes, that would be
pretty much should have actually done it during this game. But
that pretty much determines that the boxes were mismarked. That 30-plus troop condition and have 1 missile, what had the mutants? This condition says it should have been the aliens.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
So
that explains a few things.
So that's actually a problem on the side of the box itself.
Possibly, yes. Yeah.
The
so
box description.
Go from Charleston to... What the hell is that? Oh.
That is a new territory.
You get to put it wherever you want it, or is it told you to
put
it
there? Go to there.
Oh, he gets to choose where it goes.
Yeah.
That's freaking sweet.
Yeah. Well, honestly, it would have meant the last game would have been over even quicker. Either way.
Wait, we get an island that we couldn't...
Yeah. The alien island is worth 3 resource points. Aliens can only start on the alien island, as far as I remember.
Oh, God. So who are the aliens? Just Europe and America. Oh, no.
Yeah, the event cards get added to the next game. These aliens are focused on controlling and destroying cities. Their faction card includes a private mission that can earn them one red star token once per game, which actually feels weird because it has two on the thing.
Actually, if I was smart, was wanting to make things interesting, I would have put it up here and connected Greenland with science.
That would have been
from the North Pole.
That would have been neat.
There are also new scar cards used in future games. These new scars are weakness scars that are not played on the board. They go on to any non-alien faction card on the yellow sticker slot.
Let me grab a knife so I can peel that sticker off.
I'll get you a little bit.
Oh, so
interesting. These are new scars that will put stuff on faction cards. They're not automatically added now.
Oh, okay.
That looks to be it from the new alien cards. We're going to quite probably draft up another game, depending on how people are. Thank you for tuning in. We'll get back to you again with hopefully an even better way of not destroying my board.